All right, it's working now. Hello. I had to make sure everything was working for this again. Hello. Yeah, it's been a little while. It was fun. It was nice to have a night ride. It wasn't working on stuff. So, that was the whole point of it. No, it, because, Warhorse asked earlier about the showing of the video thing. No, I'm actually going to wait until next week on that, because I have one more place I got to show it before I do that. So, though I do have one part I do need some little things I need to fix on there, so it's kind of up to you guys what you want to have me do. Because I still have to work on this one. I just opened it so I could get everything preloaded. Because I still have to do all this stuff and fix up this stuff and in the next 2 months. But, under 2 months. But I can also work on that, finishing up the FMA one. I still have a couple things I actually want to do on there, even though technically it's done. I did change it. You might need to refresh it. I changed it while you were probably there. But I mean, it should be. Yeah, it says it. But anyways, so I don't know which you would prefer. If you want me to, well, you know what? Hello. The only thing I really got to do on the other one, let me find it here. I did yesterday. I wasn't secret. It emails people. Where's it going with this? I can't remember which version it was now. I think this one. No, this one. That one. Come on. Hello. Oh, well, there you go. Look, all green. That took like a whole weekend. No, but I do need to add something to the end of this. And I had an idea for what to do, but I didn't know if I wanted to. It would be a little bit of work, but not much. I'll ignore that. I forgot. I think her eyes are modified right now. Yeah. They are. Which I should probably. I don't think I need to modify these at all. But I want to change it just in case. I have a left here. Oops. I need a string called string. And that's not even a string, is it? No. Oh no, that's what it is. Okay, never mind. I have it on this one. I think it was like, I'm gonna just guess pupil. I can't see it. L dark. Yes. She looks a little creepy. Hmm. There we go. Now she's fixed. With overrides. That's why they're recorded. Still, I think that looks painful what she's doing, but that's fine. No, I need to add in... I gotta go to this map. No, this one. Oh, it's just changed a little. No, I'm fine in America. No, this, I have to, because I wanted to make it so that, because I have to do a shot where, kind of like at the end, where it just has, because there's a couple, like, custom models and stuff who did them, so I thought about doing a thing where it was like, take these two, actually I'm going to, I'm gonna save this as it is so I can save the eyes. Save as. And. Don't want to actually show stuff I can't show you yet. Actually, I don't tend to watch any of the Five Nights at Freddy's stuff. I'm not a big, I'm not a big fan of the sub-fan of that. Never played it, never cared as much. But no, I thought about doing a thing where it's like this shot, but... Why is something dark? Oh, okay. But like, just doing some like... Oh, where's the camera? Up close. Actually, I might wanna. Maybe I'll have to backed up here. I just have some close shots of this shot because I really like how the lighting is set up here. Oh, actually, I don't like that background setup though. I might play with that a little bit. Something to work on over this week, I think. They're on fire. Oh, I think I did. I don't know if I did in the stream. I went and upped the texture quality on that, so it actually looks pretty nice. I don't think that's centered. No, not really, but oh well. Because they do their spinny. Oop. With their giant hands. Yeah, I'm not gonna worry about doing that right now. I'm gonna work on the other one. That's next weekend. Oh, that's a convention. I don't even remember where I am on this though. I'm just trying to figure out that shot. Hmm. wonder if actually having this up. Oh, the quality of the VTF, yeah, kind of. It's really easy. You can do it with any of them. It just recorded as Photoshop. So where was that one? Where's my example of it? There we go. That's the final. What's it called? FM. Ah, that's what it is. As an example, I don't know if this one goes long enough. Oh, it does. Nope, but it doesn't have what I want to show. What did I do with the other one? All right. Anyways. Because there was this thinger. I had to, that's what the light on the ground is, and I had it originally as whatever size. I don't know what this one is. This is 894. But it was too small of a texture. It got literally blurry or whatever. So all I really did was just for this one, because I have, we're creating a new one from scratch, was just up this to like 2160, so that it was just bigger, because Photoshop does a much better job of scaling stuff up than compared to SFM. So I just want to scale that up here. But if you want to do it with an original, I'm just going to take some random texture. Do the marble one. Yeah, so say this, I had this texture and I wanted to have a higher quality version of it. Do know that you will require you to do your own editing. I'm just going to export this as this so that I have an editable version. This is a bad example of the type to use, because I can't really edit anything on it. But really, it's just the same thing. Just bring it in here. Go and do whatever you need to do. Increase the size. Right now it's at 512. If you bring it to 1024, you're technically giving it four times as much quality. If I take that up to 1048, you're that's four times four, so 16 times quality. But do know that if I do that, it's going to be eating a lot more memory, but the textures work based on its ratios of the sizes, not the positions. So if I increase the size of the original and save this and export it back to VTF like this, and the same texture, it still will work, where it will look the exact same, but probably just be higher quality. So if you have something with like poor text quality or whatever, export it, drastically increase the size, and just put your text over it, your own texture, and just save it back, and you can change to whatever textures you want, and you can use the original as a base. So I did that for a couple different things to make it so look a lot better. But it's pretty easy to do that. I'm not going to go and do all that for this, because you're not going to notice much of a difference from marble. But it does come in handy for that. Right, I don't see any other question then. The boxes you check are the same ones, basically. For this, if you're looking at what boxes to check here, the only ones you have to worry about are if you are using a texture that doesn't matter how it looks from a distance, so like for this one, since it's going to a wall, I'd probably just keep it base because it'll start to blur when it gets further away, lowering its detail. It helps the processing. If it's like on the actual model themselves, like for example, like on here, see with Twilight, like if you get further away, well, not that far away. If you get further away, her quality of her eyes doesn't, bad angle, doesn't differ. It still stays nice and clear. Whoa, too much. But if I were to go and save her eyes with these values, it wouldn't. It would blur. The eyes would actually start to blur when you got further away, which is something you don't want. To fix that, you just go and check the note map and no level of detail, mainly the no level of detail. That means that as you get further away, it'll still maintain the crisp look. It's a gaming engine, so it keeps track of those things. The only other thing to worry about is, as of right now, a texture is set to all repeat in every direction infinitely. So if you go and set, if you go and hit all these clamps, there, 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 and there, it makes it so the texture won't repeat in any direction. That's really the only time it's really useful is for lights, because lights otherwise, if they're not clamped, will start just emanating from every direction forward, and it can get like to where this you get infinite plane effect, which is kind of cool, but not really useful. So those are the only ones I've ever really worried about. A lot of these other things don't do, if they do much, they're not the thing I need. But I've noticed some of the models, when people do custom eyes and stuff, or custom this anything, when they went and exported the eyes, they didn't put that no bitmap, no level of detail, and you'll notice the eyes actually blur as you get further away. It's really easy to fix. Just open the texture in VTF edit, check those two boxes, save it, and you're done. It's a really quick fix. Thinking of doing something up close like this. It could be interesting. I should be. Because I was thinking, I wanted to play around sometime with, I wonder if I should try doing that now just so I know if it works. Yeah, I think I'll do that. Testing! So I'm gonna probably use a different scene. Yeah, I like the lighting on this one more, or I can crash. I'm gonna have to start splitting up this file though. Getting a little big. Do anything? No. Hello. Shalom. Over here. I'm just gonna use this one quick. I don't like this camera anyway, so who cares? Okay, so that's gonna be. Oh no, that one's staying where it is. First. There we go. So I don't really know if there's gonna be one. I'll keep one anyway. Oh, I might put that over her eye. No, there's something else I've been playing with too. I want to do that here too, just for the test thing. Wait, did I make two of those? What's this one? Ooh. No. Okay, light's coming from directly in front. That's a white. This should work. Okay, I'm gonna have way too zoomed in. There we go. I just want to make the eyes twitchy. So I'm going to make them. Where do they go? Here. Not that way. I wonder if some jitter would work. Kind of, not really though. I want to make sure I test this with motion, that's why I'm doing it this way. Okay. Not. Oh yeah, I do need to do those. Smooth. Okay, when the eyes go up here, it's gonna be eyelids should react. I'm just testing a few things. That's gonna be eyelids should go Raise. It's not going. Oh, it's sad, that's why. So the. That goes up. That goes up. It's another Twitch. Okay, I think that should work. But I still think that it needs a little bit more lighting over here. Brighten this one. No, I wouldn't say I encouraged them in any way. That was completely them. I just had way too many other things I had started and I couldn't take on anymore. Me lost at sea.
Okay. Let's see if this is something I can do. I'm going to... Sport Ori. Yeah, keep it 720. I'm just gonna drop the colonies. I just wanna see if I can do something here. Oh, good. We'll take off. Might need to drop that eye brightness a little bit, but. So I want to see if I can cause artificial reflections and that actually look legitimate. Without referring, going to, what do you call that? Those weird texture things I was working on before. Because that really wouldn't give a realistic reflection, it would just cause something that looked artificial. A little bit more. Then I just gotta render one little part. But it's like, it's, I want to do something like this, but I don't know if it'll work, and I don't want to waste my time doing it if it won't work. Alright, good night. Grab it from this shot. So much going on though. No, screw it. Which light is causing that? Oh, there it is. Okay. Be off to the side a little bit, so it'd be like this. I think so. Okay, that's 1,000. Okay, it still didn't work out how I wanted it to. Well, that works. For the most part, yeah. I'm trying to create the background reflection then, so do that. Okay. Ooh, where'd it go? Can't do that. That'll work. Okay. Technically, that might be the right direction, but I'll just mirror it. Yeah, it would be. Come on. There we go. That is... Well, that's in the folder already, isn't it? Yes, it is. I'll just wait for that to be done. to go upside down. That should work. Did that. That's weird. Okay, now can I do that there? Oops. I think this is not the tool I want though. No. No, but it does kind of work, but... I just keep it like that for now and see what happens. I wish you could scroll down these like you could some of the others. No. That's how I used to level up Photoshop. Okay, so I need lightning, so it's not gonna be that. That could work, but it's too light. It's probably gonna be add? No. No. Well, maybe. No. Ooh, that could... maybe. Probably an easier way to do this. Ooh. Oh, it makes it too dark on the edges, though. Ooh. That could almost work a little better. Oh. No, it does it to the whites. No. Well, no. She's evil. I think I might just go back to the this color dodge. Yeah, I'll just keep it at that. One thing I don't like about the sphere is how it is there is that it should be stronger around the edges, but why is it skipping right in the middle there? Broken right in that. Right there. In the darkest part of the eye. Because I just don't like that. That, like, is it a milky. Ugh. I'm thinking I could color it differently and it would work better. Other ones again. I think that one, no. You know what? I have an idea. There you go, that's better. Excuse me. Liquify might be what I'm looking for. No, that's going to be a lot of work, though. Warp? What does that do? Arc. Boozer. Bulge. That could work. There we go. Might be this one. Fish eye. Yeah, that kind of did it. So I'm going to say this is right. Come on, there it goes. There. And... let's see if this is scaling correctly. Okay. Just seeing if this works, it'd be kind of cool. Okay, and then another mask. Well, that's weird. Actually, I wonder with how it was before. Oh no, it just brings it back. Actually, it's... Oh no, it gets rid of the original mask. Ah, okay, not with that. Can I do invert? Oh, those intersect. Nah. I'm doing this a really messy way right now because I don't care as much. I just wanted to see if it works. I would mask this a lot closer, but so up till here. That's gonna pull in a bit. And then from right here. Right there. I don't think this is going to work for animating this, but I will try. Whatever, it'll give an idea as to what it, if it'll work. It's horrible, but whatever. Does that actually work as a reflection, though? That's what I'm more curious about than anything. What are you guys talking about? That actually could work. Instead of this mask doing this, I'm gonna have it do... There. Yeah, then this would be... I'm checking to see if I can do live reflections in the eyes by taking two videos and overlaying it on each other. I'm just doing it really cheaply right now to see if it's something that would work. So technically this is the doors video. I shouldn't have it moving as much as it is, or at least I should have it bending to the shape. But I wanted to see if it was something that would work, and in a way it does. I had an idea for it to in a different video like that, so I thought I'd try it here. And in a way I could see it working. It's just right now just horribly masked. If I could see it. I could see it working. It would just take a lot of masking to actually follow the edges of the eyes under every frame. But it would work. I think I might keep that and just figure it out later. And if it doesn't work, I can just keep the eye part and just say whatever. I'm gonna key that just so I know what I'm for the future. There's a reason everything wants to think really hard right now. It does work, so I mean, I guess I didn't. It's not that I didn't think it wouldn't work, it's just that I don't know how difficult it was gonna be. Oh, that light is still so bright, too. What I'm trying not to do is keep these two evenly spaced. This part I can understand a little bit because it was with beat, but this part I just don't want to have it being all with the beat. Integral part. Once I get all these in the red, at least then I can, or where I'm happy, I can really start pushing it out, but... I don't know what to do here, though. this has got to be the where the door's shown. Originally, I think I had the. Do I still have the camera? No, I don't. It was like back here or something. Doing anything here would break the 180 rule. I can't do that. So at this point, copy paste it if I need to fix it. See, I was paying attention. No, because I can use that as a little bit of an in-between to do this shot then. Because I had to be able to focus on her, so I had to have a shot where it gave a reason to. So that's what this one is. And then I can technically have a shot then where... here, aperture way up. This is so stoic. I forgot to turn off the oven. Keep it locked to them at this point. Okay, then unlock. I think I can play at this point, right? Let me just stop. Okay. I think Celestia's is quite a bit cake. Yeah, I'm pretty sure. Yes. One can fit inside the others. Digital princess. Majestic. Technically, that could work. I must find this out. Okay. So is he on the ground? Yes, okay. Normally this is just because everything needs to be retoided. We are spun 90 degrees. And then that fixes things. If I can cheat this. Haha. Kind of. Yeah, I don't think that worked right. That's all it is. Usually, it's just all the bones have one little rotation wrong. So you just fix it. And as long as everything stays locked, it doesn't break the final motion. You get some pretty funny results too. Alright, so this leg. Oh, that was actually easier than I thought it was going to be. It's like a really big fairy. Tail, I'm gonna leave. Oh. I don't know if this is going to do much to it. I think they're just... Oh, wait, wait. Wait. Oh, they're effed. Now she got big wings. Could use some other things I learned to make this work too. She's really thin. Oops. There we go.
Once upon a time, there was a charming prince, warm soul in arms of steel, but luckless on his love. Once upon a time, an angel prayed for him, they had a destiny.
All right, I'm gonna give her two horns. Well, that was tied in, right?
Though the shadows try to keep our hearts away forever, it never came true. My love was within you.
Yeah. Well, that's why.
Made me wonder. And before I knew it, she was on my heart, and drowned just with this sorrow. You're gone.
Still didn't override though. Oh well. Oh yeah, I need to hide those two. But you know what? No. See if I can do it with the wings then. There we go. Okay. Let's see if this works. Kind of. What am I clicking? Oh, I know what you did. like kind of working. I'm gonna get this to work. Let's. Probably just type this one in wrong then. It was defaulting to something else. It should be this coin. This. That. There we go. Overrides are pretty damn powerful. I think the problem right now is these feet are too far off the ground. Oh, I can actually pull them down. There, so that's. Now that your front legs are still a little bit anorexic. There. Yeah, but that. This way. Move your head. Way down back there. I'll just move her head. I'll move everything with it. Thank you. Invent that. That was a lot of work for something so simple. Did she have a center thing too? Yes, dirt collar. I don't know if it's the same shape, but we'll figure that out. No, it's not. Okay, I'm gonna put that back to normal. See if instead I can just do a color override on it. I'll make it very blue, less yellow, so let's do 22.82. I'm gonna make gray. That's actually kind of cool too. I want more blue. Oh, now it's just purple. Never gonna be able to hit that color with it, no matter how hard I try. Well, maybe. No, not really. But I do kind of like that. Oh, the gem is a different color? No, it's not. I thought I tried looking that up before. Yeah, whatever. It'll work. And crown. Okay. Gem. Is this what I think it is? Gem. I'm not sure. Oh, I think it's something that's not visible on here or something. Maybe. Yeah, because cloth, there's no cloth on here either. But you know, I can, it's cool because I can load anything up that I want onto this one then. As long as I can load it to this model. So like, here, let's save this because it really doesn't matter. I can't actually change the gem's color. I thought I could because I had something called gem, but I don't know. I think it's a texture that's attached to the model but isn't actually used. work. Hey, let me try that again. I could go into the actual texture and modify it, but it's kind of fun just to see what you can do without actually doing any texture modifications. Just off of, I never forgot to post stuff, didn't I? Whatever, too late now. I'm just trying to think of some other animation I could load onto her with that. That'd be funny. I can only think of one. Wow, it's taking a long load. I wonder if I'm max memory just opening that one now. Oh, no. I know what it is. I actually can't open that one right now, that's why. Okay. But I can open... I can't open that one right now because it's... has assets in it that I have frozen right now. To free up assets for other stuff. I should be able to open this one. I don't have the some of that stuff saved, so. Plus, I can't take her out of that shot. All those locks and stuff, I can't unlock them to move her to a new shot. It's stuck. It's fun to be able to do this stuff, but I'm kind of limited on what I can do with it. Okay. Actually, it might be this one. Oh, I think it's just the lip syncing? Whatever, it's gonna be this now. Oh, I had to see that for something. Okay. Do any job modifications there because I can't do that on Twilight. No, I didn't. And technically, I could make it better if I just retextured her directly. Oh, I can't do it because they're locked. No, because the eyes are locked. No, it still won't let me. I can cheat it.
there's not gonna be any music, but come on, look, you're still just. She's like screaming. Oh, there we go. Oh, I didn't grab. I only grabbed the one bit. That's why. Okay. There we go. Oh, next shot. It tells a story. I think I still have that. What scene was that in? Who was the last one? Well, that was Chop Chop. A spike running a circle. It's dead. Nom nom chicken. Oh yeah. Grab with that one. Yeah. Okay. Did I save that one? No, I had to have. Maybe I didn't. I don't think I saved the Hydra. No. Apparently I didn't. At least I can't find it. Nope. Okay. Okay, you get your fix on that. It's like so much set up to do all these stupid things. Which song? The last one that was playing was Auto Machine Red Sorrow. What about? Oh, hold up. Yeah. Oh, wait. Probably. I think I'll just leave her back here. Keep it all wet, fuck folders. I have two? Oh, the carp bones. Yeah, I forgot I got rid of them. So many empty stuffs. Oh god. Screw that. There, now I got it. Actually, for a lot of the last month, I was working on the FME stuff, chemistry. But that one's done. I just have to do some final editing on. I do like this shot right here, but I don't like how the lighting looks. Where is... I just highlight, there we go. Oh wait, I don't need it to actually animate like that, so just like this. That's why it was bad. Oh, they're still locked! Sweet! Okay, that actually made it a lot easier. I think the backlights are not set up right, but I can't change them too much because otherwise it's going to look like a weird transition. Even that alone you can say is a little weird, because she's got no light around her nose here, but then light around her nose there, but stuff that isn't noticed. And the rim. It's gonna be hard because I like the lighting on her probably like this, but as soon as she turns her head, it's like everything just explodes into light. Probably be better if I took the mane, brought that around more, balance a little more. Just that she is so bright. I'll figure out something later.
With that, crazy.
Do I have eye lights for everybody, or is it just her? I need it for both. She does kind of look a little maniacal there, though.
Okay, yeah, that is the spot that's left, too. I mean, it's still a little bit.
But I want to see, where are her eyes? They're under, like,
overhaul system, right? Yeah. Pupil left. How big is this? Normal size. So it's just the way it's scaled? And they're not the... That's the old eyes, isn't it? Because these are like the big shiny ones, and then these ones are the fairly plain ones. Are they the same color as hers? Let's see what happens if I do this. Overrides are like the most amazing thing. I turned a Rainbow Dash into a Lunar Guard using overrides. And gave a mechanical leg using overrides. It required a couple models melded on top of each other, but it was really not much for actual texture modifications. If you really play with it, you can do some really cool things with it. The fact that you're able to just... I mean, I could go, like, for that other Twilight thing, I could have just said screw it and did this instead. Said base texture, taken her entire body texture and just redirected it to, oops, Twilight Sparkle. There. I could have just done that too. And then, voila, we have Twilight Sparkle as a purple horse. It doesn't work for everything like that because it has to be everything's set up to look the same, but you could technically do it that way. It's got her cuties and everything. That was easy. And then if you want to get rid of it, bam. You didn't actually change the model at all. You just changed it in this one shot. Or any that you have as the overrides for it. I mean, what's the other one I could do? This is one I think this is so cool you can do this. So there's... right, left, and then, well, that's just sets of very tiny, because that's her, I guess. But, for the eyes, then, I could say, right. I know I need the left right now. I could override Iris. And I could say instead of even going anybody here, I could say go to Lunar, which is the Lunar Guard, and this actually pupil. Left. And now I have the Evil Eyes, or what is Sombra's name? King Sombra? Yes. Keeps jumping me out. Okay. King Sombra. There. Now I have his eyes. And I'm not sure how the eyes work in regard. Let me go. The actual background. I will left evil, but how am I getting that? That's base texture. Okay. So then I could say eyeball tribute. To be eyeball left evil. There. Now I have Sombra eyes. And I didn't actually change the model at all. I didn't even move textures. All I did was redirect them to a different folder. Voila. And the nice thing is you can actually give the different sized pupil because of that. So I can make one small, one large by overriding it to the smaller versions. So it's pretty easy. It's just all it is just adding an attribute of whatever appropriate one in here. So that's in this case, Iris. You want to have a string, base texture have a string, and just replacing. Only thing you can't really control is anything outside these main parentheses. So I can't change it from eyes to something else, but I can override everything else. So I'm just going to delete that. Go back to white. Then here I want to go to. Okay, so that's as Twilight's eye, but it's the same size. So her eye scaling is way smaller. And I don't think there's a way to actually scale it outside of it. Not without changing it to eye refraction, but then that makes her... Did I have to make the eyes smaller or bigger when I did that? I had to make them smaller. Let me try something. There we go. I didn't want to go that one. Over here. Okay. Should actually double the size of her iris. It just depends. Like for this, I wanted to if you overize the eyeball, eyeball texture is actually just the whites, the actual eyeball, while the pupil is the actual texture of the that's in the center. Okay, maybe her eyes aren't set up for that, or did I might have. Oh, man, actually these. Nope, those were old ones. Do I not have the folder set up for this anymore? I might not. Also, I am trying to get her textures. That's... there. I can't remember what I did to get that to work. I know I changed something else, but... Or is it because the iris is overridden? No, this kind of looks cool. As of right now, it's just saying there's like... It's not just invalid. I wonder if I gotta remove all... Overrides? No. I can't remember what I did. There was something else. Oh, the black and purple box is just a default texture if there's nothing else. That's if I go and say... If I have it... Overrides. Why is there... Suddenly, very few textures on her. Oh, because her eyeballs don't have them. No, that should still be her armor and everything.
Of course, we had to use potato
six. I think I broke Celestia. I'm gonna put her eyeballs back to normal. I might try to do that later. One thing that was really annoying to me of trying to get the eyes to work correctly for the refraction was that you had to recompile the models to make it really work. There it goes. Yeah, for some reason I was breaking the model. No, but say I go to the body here, and I go to just add attribute string, and I say redirect base texture. Well, as soon as I do it, it overrides it, but it doesn't know where it is, because it's blank. So she goes and becomes this default black and purple texture, because it's saying, I don't know what body to use. But I can put anybody on there, so I can... Bon is best princess. So is there a way to... I'm gonna check here. Texture names. Okay, I'd like to make sure is where's its parents. That's just a list of all of them. You have another way to do this. No. There we go, eye shader. Haha, okay. Now is there... Oh, I can set the diameter? Oh, that'd be cool. I want it to roll inside the head. Scale of the iris. Okay, let's see if that works. Oh no, that's not settable. No, those don't work. That's not. Yeah, that's within the definition of. You're not directing me to where I want to be. Yeah, eye refract has way more control. So the eye probably just doesn't have much at all. Oh well. So that would be nice to be able to just scale it up instead of having to worry about the actual texture itself. Oh well. It seems like her eye is really small. Okay, well... I guess I can kind of understand from the front, it looks okay. Where'd she go? There we go. Hey, I was working on this one like an hour ago. trying to find timing here. That head turn would be done much earlier than that. Actually, I wonder if I can just... How far is she walking? Ah, sweet. Yeah, yesterday's was recorded. I thought about still putting it up on the normal Livestream thing, just make another thing for it. It was pretty fun. It was nice just randomly crap bullshitting with people. Next weekend is a con. That's why I'm not going to be streaming next Friday. As I might, and that's a big might, do next Tuesday, but it's going to be dependent on a few things, so if I do, I will say something. Strong camera. Yeah, I'm not that great at the game. It just was fun. That's all that mattered. We were trying to tackle for what game to play, and came down to Payday or that. And I was like, yeah, I think it'd be more fun to get a lot of people in. Okay, I need to think of this in terms of bars. I really like the cinematic bar on there. So I want to try to keep that. Well, Taco was just like, it was actually fun to die to just because it was Taco. I think I might move that to here. Yeah, we were playing yesterday. We started out with TF2 and then we moved to Payday 2. I only played a couple and then I had to go to bed, but I really want to work on that follow video, but I can't. Nanto still hooves.
I need to steal the hooves. Steel Hooves and Pyrolite. Pyrolite's kind of an but I can't do anything until Steel Hooves is done. To me, it just feels like I can't focus on what I want to get done on it unless I have the access to everything. But when you're playing Payday with a guy that's like infamous level 17, that kind of just walks around and owns everything, it doesn't matter. So I gotta keep the music going on this part so I know the timing. It's just that after doing the FMA one, I realized that I can do action pretty well, because I did a lot of really cool scenes with such, but again, I don't want to do anything until Steel Hooves. Yeah, that's a much better way of transitioning than I have. But then obviously I have her looking down here and have it her turn right here. So at this point have her doing the same thing as in this shot, just looking over. Oops. Down. I have her head down a bit. Not so happy. Careful when I do that. If I round it too much, I'll actually destroy the normal head bob, which makes her head look weird. I thought he had the model, but there's a lot more to do to it, textures and all that. But But again, I have to finish this one before I start putting any time in anything else. Well, this and two other small things, but I can't show those. So I think that could work. It's like the same zoom, isn't it? One thing I don't like about this shot is I feel there's too much red here. There's nothing to break it up. It does further in, but I feel like early on it needs something else, but I might not be able to do anything about that. I feel like this one's gonna be more expansive. What's the field of zoom? Oh, maybe I can't play with that then. Actually, I like it like that. Because it just gives that feeling of immensity. I might actually have her back up a few steps then. I'm gonna say that these are okay for now. Or I can crash it. I like putting weird things in the background. Probably lost some of the stuff in the shots. Right wonder if I was. I have the camera go the other way. No, because it's going to. Yeah, maybe. Only thing that's tough is that I think. No, I don't have any modified field of view on this. Or did I override it when I did that? Yes, yeah, that's what I did. Okay, so actually I want to do this manually then. Okay, gotta make sure I'm not showing the bottom of her feet. Okay. It does blend a little better if I do it that way. But it kind of doesn't give that changing your perspective along the way that I like. Might just leave it as is then. Ah, that's what did it. Okay, I guess I can't put a zero there. You can't really reset the colors, which sucks. Okay, so 1 to 0, 0, 0, 0. There, okay. Okay, so sign. Actually, the bottom values don't need to be changed. Oops.
She does like some magic in here. I'm trying to figure out how I want to do it here. That look. Hello. Our wobbly camera is bothering me. Just trying to figure out where the wobble is. Having your belt center here actually does work better. I'm not violating rule of thirds or anything, it's because that's not a requirement. Playing with cameras is so fun. There, that works. Oh, the FMA one's done. I just have like a couple little fixes I need to do. Before, the main thing was just to get it to con display worthiness. And it is. The screens usually displayed at those places are lower, you know, because they're a projection or something. So, small little things you can get away with. So I said to fix, it's mainly just render them out a couple more times to see if I can get some lighting errors to just not happen. Just trying to smooth out a couple of these extra little cameras are really bumpy. Oh, that actually fixed a lot of error there. Right now, it should be this one. Oh, it is Marune from Cartographer. Little hiccups in the camera I was trying to fix. I'm just finding the spots where it suddenly decides that it needs to drastically change direction. Still doing it. Actually, I don't know if I'm gonna get rid of that one. Yeah, I could probably just work with having it anyway.
trying to see if there's just anything interesting besides the... Again, it's not good.
Well, yeah, we showed it at Everfree, on last weekend. Wow, that was still last weekend. And then I'm just holding off on it till after MLP MSB, which is next, not this weekend, but the weekend after that. And I hope to have the editing done this week, so that basically during the panel I can just have somebody hit the button for it. I think it'd be fun to have somebody else hit, say... video done here, hit the button for me. So it might be like Saturday. Well, you know what, I might not do that, just because it'd be coming out at the same time as episode 100, and I'm wondering if that might be a bit of a bad timing to put a video out. Actually, it would be almost in 45 minutes afterwards. So yeah, I might not do that. Actually, I might wait until like Monday. Seems a little wobbly at the end there. I hate cameras that don't go fully straight, but the more motions you give it, the harder it gets. So like, I probably want to actually have it so it's like in right there to stop, then around it so that it comes to a stopping point. That's the thing, part of it too, is it stops going backwards and it just starts lifting. The motion for that is right here.
Like, I might do, I'm not sure if Bryce is okay. I usually put it to a pretty soft.
Yeah, I might just leave it. We have to figure out that after bit here. Yeah, I like the shot, but I don't think that's not gonna work. Actually, the amazing focus that it doesn't have.
Fighting surfaces back there.
No, the it's more of things get drowned out if you put out. There's been video games themselves that have come out, or movies come out at the same time as a really, really big movie or a really big title, and it gets so drowned out by it that it's just you don't see it. So that's why putting it out the same hour as episode 100 coming out, yeah, you'll get some people, but it's more of people's excitement over that will just, while they may have watched it, they'll just forget about it, and so I don't want to do that. I'll wait until like Monday or something. I've been trying to teach myself patience in that regard. The reason I don't like that too is that at this point she's supposed to be starting magic to get that to open. Halfway through. foliage away so I'd have a different scene. It could work if the blink led to higher eye headphones. Maybe.
Okay.
No, I didn't. I just haven't said anything. Called focus. Don't like where that light's placed here. I should have blinked anyway. Oh, I see. Turn that manually. Well, anytime you're close up to something, you need to have a lot of detail to it. I don't even know why I'm putting this much detail to it now, because I still have to do a lot of other stuff, but... And I want to have that shine in the eye there, because it makes it... it's fitting. I actually was playing around with that with the FMA video. I did it with a bunch of shots. Added a glowing eyes. It's just getting it... The nice... or the cool thing about it is it because in some of these, it's not moving with the eye, like... The eye's moving, but the light's not, so it kind of creates a false sense of a reflection, which is what an eye would normally do. But also, if you hit just in the back here, it just has this nice bright bit that it just kind of shows the direction the light's coming from, it just comparative to an eye that doesn't. It's kind of neat effect. So, getting it to work correctly is the hard part. And it's just an eye light normally, like an override one, just... It's set to a very, very small area. I think with that video too, I was dimming it every time the eye blinked too. I think I even had one where it got brighter when it opened. Do like a flash. The only thing I don't like about it right now is the... is from here to here. So from this eye movement to this eye movement is really... I need to make a shorter period of time. Like almost instant. But, the eyelids always move with the eye too. That's why, like... I have to make it so that the eye does some kind of twitch thing when the eyeball moves. Left and right is really difficult because there's not much up and down that it moves, but anytime a pupil itself moves and looks up or down, it's technically the eyelid should move with it.
Like one superior or three
foveal. Like here I have the top lid open, but it should actually go down a little bit. I was just going to make it so it's not just left and right. A little bit up in there too. I wonder if that'll work. No, it just ruined it. Just a little bit of smooth then. I guess the end of this bit then. It seemed a little bit stopping too quick. I don't even know if I'll keep it, but I thought it'd just be something fun to do there. I'm not sure, because I need to break it up a little bit. And I do need to figure out what to do here then. Because she's going to do magic stuff, door open, I'm not sure what to do here with her though. Let's see what the lead up is, maybe that'll help. I know what to do. Oh, that didn't grab the camera, did it? Because by doing it up close here, technically I'm went to a shot where I'm hiding part of her face. The part is I didn't want to go and show a full part of her face because the only way I'd be able to do a full part of her face is like to go from like a shot like this that would then lead into it so that it has a direction it's going into to get to the eye. But that would be kind of stupid when the shot like this was about the same. And even it's not that bad, but I think instead I'm gonna take the camera and put it here where I can see her mouth. Oh, I'm gonna big zoom in, aren't I?
It's just ugly. I really hate this guy.
Yeah, I'm gonna do a big zoom. And have it so instead that she goes and pulls her hoof up like to her chest. Anything that I've done that already? No. So, like, here. The reason I kind of just put myself right in the middle of that door, didn't I? Magic! Now, the reason I do that is because getting up like that is not easy. Without breaking things. You gotta churn some parts of it and then churn other parts and pull them out, and it's not fun. Turning the camera just kind of ruins it, so I can't do that. But I want to show her mouth just a little bit. my, or is it higher then? Should I raise it higher? I might have to pull this back further. It was up higher. Turn this out more. Turn this in more. Why would you want to get rid of them? It's hilarious. I think it works perfect. And I'm taking that you're talking about Spitfire's eyes that are probably the ones that are there. Easy, just add a scale to the head and scale it down to zero. It is quite entertaining. Except if it's another bot, a model locked in there, yes, I would just scale the head down. I think actually this kind of has a cool aspect of it, because it suddenly hits a point that after she opens everything, the world kind of quiets down in a way. You know what? I want to check something. That. Technically, that's not what I wanted. This one then, yeah. No, actually, I did want that one. Let me see if that gets rid of the blurriness. Though it's kind of okay, too, but. The only reason I don't like it is that it puts everything off of kilter. Oh, that actually worked. Okay, well, now the floor isn't blurry. See, things like that fix things. It's not like how it blurs, it still makes the lines kind of off, but I want to make sure that doesn't like weird some shots out or something. Although, the normal level of detail does that for me. Kind of pleases me. I don't know what you're talking about. I think this is perfect. It looks perfect. It's so beautiful. I don't know what planet he's from, but he's beautiful. Either you're hating on him just because he's got extra large eyes. Love and tolerate, man. This camera suddenly got broken again. Or it's been busted still and I just haven't cared. It's kind of like Spike was when I did the thing.
They say for the first week you're not supposed to. Well, probably for the first 4 days you should be doing this. It's just easier to get one of them to get plus, I can already tell that.
How short that shot is, I can't do too much camera movement with it. I can do it. I want to do a little bit though. I don't think you could sneak up and murder this guy. I think he could see you from any direction possible. You could probably see into the future.
Wow.
Look at that. It's a face of innocence. He's just a victim. Why would you hurt him? Why? Wait, now resize the window. Damn it. He's wedging you. And I'm like, all my windows size specifically for sitting over here, and I messed it up. There we go. Maybe your start is a dejected look then. I'm okay with it, Jamie, not dog. When I go with this, I need to readjust the lights then. Mainly because I don't see her popping on that side. So, you know, get her separated. There. That is all it is, add that little line there, and then suddenly it pops her out of there. Without that, she just kind of blends into the background. It's just her back leg right here. But bam! How do you render while you're on your computer? I think I've done, I only render in the evening if I'm on a time crunch and I have to get it done, and I had that happen not just recently. Then I will render in the evening. My problem is, I think Celestia's still technically in the shot. She might be just in the back corner, but I can hide her. I love about putting so much time into these, but I still don't even consider it started. Okay, the shadow that's on her face right now. Mark shot. Okay, so it's just sitting there. I thought that I had it set to animate. Oh, no, that's not it. The doors were... So just both these. I thought these were set to move or something. I guess not, so I will do it myself. It's something, because... Oh no, it's because the shadow set this so well. It does just pop in there, but I'll fix it somehow. Well, that's locked. Okay, that's not what I want. It's not gonna do it in a nice clean. Which means, what if I take the doors instead and just slide them apart? It still goes in sections. What if I move the light? Still the same. Why am I upside down? Only it's a little light on her forehead, so I can do it from here. Now I should be able to be fine.
How is the boss for this?
better. Whoa. And then suddenly Rainbow Dash. What about the awesome, the music can make you broke? Or are you buying all of it? Increase to that. Have the shadows start pretty thick, and then as it gets increased, have the shadows get more blurred like a normal shadow would. Okay. I just use the YouTube for it, but I mainly use it for all the music because I can share it with other people, and because I use it also for finding the music. There's so many times where I'll go through some like 3-hour mix and I'll find something I like, and I can easily go to that person's channel, because normally if they have a 3-hour mix, they have the individual songs. I can just go bam, add it to the playlist, done. But yeah, there's a lot of awesome, awesome musicians, and I'm starting to find common names. Actually, I've been listening to non-orchestral stuff a little bit more lately. I got addicted to Starset, which is a pretty awesome man. Okay, so these shots are actually turning out pretty good. I do like the how it goes, everything's visible here until she opens the door. Then at that point, what you see of her is limited until, well, almost 30 or 40 more seconds in, until this point where she's still hiding her face. So it kind of goes from a hidden face to a hidden face.
So I wasn't sure if there was something that I was missing or what.
Okay, I'd say at least for now the cameras are set. I mean, I put a lot more detail into these parts than I wanted to right now, but it's getting there. And then this shot obviously is nowhere near set up how I want it to be. It's going to be a little bit more involved. so that's why I just put the default there. It should probably be the first one I work on, but I think I want to kind of get everything around it situated first, because once that one started, I really can't change it. So how's that looking so far? Oh, I think I hit too many buttons at once there. No way. Got five bars. We might play with that camera a little bit. I don't like how it crosses. What poster? I think I missed something. Oh, you can do whatever you want. Oh, wait, I'm playing through there. I don't know if I like the timing there. Still seems a bit rushed there. Oh, wonderful. I can barely contain my enthusiasm. You can't out-goof me. Error. Stuff off on that. Thank you. Day. No, I'm not. Okay. Yes. I'm just on the back. I just love that. Oh, we're gonna just stop. Actually, rendered out, that'd be kind of interesting looking too. Other than my legs are eating her wing. That, no. Still gotta make picture so I can put the model out. I think I've placed myself in like half the shots of this. And I'm not really that great with particles, I just know how to modify them. Did I turn those off? Okay, elements need to be on. Oh, speed particles, there we go. I still gotta figure out if that will work on. When I slow it down, it technically wraps correctly, but I don't know how. So I think it would. I know, I think I tried it on render and it didn't work, so I think the solution was to render it at 60 FPS and just drop it down.
I like how you dashed into me so that the frickin' boss then jumped and attacked me.
Okay. I am beautiful. I look like the Pip-Boy.
Oh, shit.
In like a creepy way.
I just totally wasted that entire thing because it spun me around the wrong way.
There you go. Have me. I totally don't have a problem. I go intensifies. Don't be scared. I'm only right behind you. That is creepy though. A bobblehead. Yeah. All right. So I might actually. Well, no, I gotta still do some of that part. But that part's actually mostly done. There's no guard. Oh, there's guards visible. Damn it. That means I gotta put all the guards back. There. Actually, there's a lot of lighting I have to throw back in there then. But, flower pots wise, I only have one half of the hall to worry about. So I'm going to say visible, no. Delete lights. Delete. And this all. Delete. Door's not visible, but I'm using it for the lighting. But I don't need the frame then. Actually, I might. No, I narrowed it down to that little beam. That's... I'm just trying to give it a little bit more processing power here. That helped. There's only one twilight. Like on here, I have all these flower pots on this shot too, don't I? Yep, and none are visible. Technically, the door's not even visible. Oh, I want to keep the door a little bit, like kind of like the other one. Nope. Actually, I have to keep it all. I can get rid of one of the frames. Yeah, I'll get rid of that one. Oh, there's a lock. Yes. There. Process better. If I noticed too much, it should have called it that. So, that's brilliant. Alright, but there's not much I'm going to be able to start tonight still, so I'm probably going to cut it here. Like I said, I'm not, I'm at the convention next week, so there may be Tuesday, but otherwise it's probably none next week. But then we'll be back to normal the week after. Oh boy. Oh yeah, there's music. So, yeah, that is kind of quiet. So, anyways, so yeah, that's the gist of it. If any of you are at MLPMSB next week, awesome. If you're not, sucks to be you. Yeah, I know. But then there's not another one for 2 months. Before going out to Baltimore, but that's whether or not I need to get this thing done for. So I might, depending on how when it starts getting closer, might just see how much I have to push it out. But no, it's sitting at 4.5 minutes. Wow. Sorry, the recording will be up tomorrow sometime, whenever I remember that it was up and recorded and all that. So, anyways, yep, I will. Otherwise, I'll tell you guys later. So,
bye bye.